Hello friends! In this video, we will take a look at a Zigbee sensor from the well-known manufacturer Moes. It is designed to measure temperature and relative humidity. Thanks to such sensors, smart home systems can create automations for climate control, such as managing air conditioners, humidifiers, underfloor heating, and radiators. In my previous video, I reviewed a similar case where the temperature from such a sensor was synchronized with controllable thermostatic heads to maintain a set room temperature. The link to the lesson is in the description. I will test the sensor's compatibility with various smart home control systems, as well as the update speed and data accuracy. More details coming up, but for now, as always, I kindly ask you to like this video so that more people interested in smart home topics can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Device type, temperature and relative humidity sensor. Model, Moes ZSS-S01-TH. Interface, Zigbee 3.0. Temperature measurement range, from minus 10 to plus 60 degrees Celsius. Humidity measurement, from 0% to 99%. Battery type, CR2032. Size, 40 by 26 by 13 millimeters. The device comes in a small cardboard box, designed in the manufacturer's style. It indicates the sensor type and interface, the Tuya Smart logo, and supported systems, Google Home and Amazon Alexa. In the package, besides the sensor itself, there is also a small manual and a piece of double-sided tape for surface mounting. The most detailed description is in English, while other languages have a shortened version. However, the manual is not particularly necessary, as everything here is standard and familiar. I have come across different variations of such sensors, which can be roughly divided into two categories, those with a screen displaying current parameters and those without. Since I bought this sensor to replace an Accra sensor that had stopped working after nearly 8 years of use on the balcony, I chose the version without a screen. The backside is removable and serves as the battery compartment cover. The tape is attached to it, meaning only the cover is secured to the surface, and the sensor itself can be removed, for example, to replace the battery. At the top of the sensor, there are air intake holes for conducting measurements. There is also a button. A short press triggers a connection check with the coordinator, while a long press switches it to pairing mode. When this happens, an LED starts blinking, which is visible through the holes in the casing. The sensor uses the most common CR2032 battery. To prevent discharge during transportation, a protective tab is placed between the battery and the contacts. This tab needs to be removed before use. For comparison, here it is next to a round Zigbee sensor from Xiaomi. The size is approximately the same as most other sensors of this class. Now let's move on to compatibility testing. We will start with the default control system, Tuya Smart. To connect, a Zigbee gateway is required. I am using a wired version with Apple HomeKit support. I navigate to the section for adding new devices and start a search. After that, I press and hold the button on the sensor until the LED under the casing starts blinking. The gateway then detects it, and the image in the plugin matches the actual appearance of the sensor. The sensor appears in the system. The plugin displays the current temperature and humidity values, and there is a graph of changes, which can be viewed by day, month, or year. The settings menu shows the battery level and includes two notification settings for low battery and high temperature. In the general settings menu, compatibility with Amazon Alexa and Google Home is indicated. There is also an option to check the firmware, grant shared access, or remove the sensor from the system. In automations, the sensor can only function in the if section as a trigger, since no direct actions are provided for it. Only receiving air condition data is possible. There are three trigger options available: temperature readings, relative humidity, and battery level. You can set them to be greater than, less than, or equal to a selected value. As soon as the threshold is reached, the automation will trigger. My Tuya Smart account is linked to Google Home through the compatible devices menu. The sensor, as stated, is supported here. All values, temperature, relative humidity, and battery level, are displayed. Here's how the sensor data appears on the Google Nest screen. Additionally, you can ask the voice assistant for information about air parameters. As I mentioned earlier, the gateway I connected the sensor to is compatible with HomeKit and is linked through this protocol to the corresponding integration in Home Assistant. In the original Home app, everything will look the same. And although such compatibility was not officially stated, the sensor's data, except for the battery level, also appeared here. This is undoubtedly a plus. And while the sensor is still connected to the gateway, let's check whether it will work with Home Assistant through the default Tuya integration. I should note that the sensor operates simultaneously in all the systems shown so far. Here, we have full compatibility with all data available, including the battery level. However, it is worth mentioning that this integration depends on internet access. Now it's time to disconnect from the default gateway and move on to alternative coordinators. As usual, we will start with Sonoff iHost, a local smart home control center. The firmware version at the time of testing is 2.4.3. It has its own built-in Zigbee coordinator, allowing it to directly manage devices using this interface. The sensor was successfully connected and was externally recognized as a model with a round screen. Incidentally, I previously reviewed a similar one. This is how it appears on the device panel. The letter E in the upper right corner of the tile indicates that this is an end device, meaning it cannot relay data for other nodes in the Zigbee network. All parameters are displayed: temperature, relative humidity, and battery level. The battery level may not appear immediately, which is normal. Over time, data on air parameter changes will accumulate and be displayed in graph form. There is even an option to export data if needed. In the general settings menu, you can change the temperature scale between Celsius and Fahrenheit. In automations, the sensor can also function only as a trigger, an event that causes automation to be executed. You can set threshold values for temperature and humidity, which will serve as activation points. iHost supports the Matter protocol, which, among other things, allows it to act as a bridge for other control systems, in this case, Google Home. This method also allows data to be received from this sensor. However, compared to the previous method of adding it via the Tuya Smart account, the amount of available data here is slightly reduced. The battery level is missing. However, it is still accessible in the iHost interface. Now, we return to Home Assistant again, first checking compatibility with the default integration for working with Zigbee devices, ZHA. I am using a coordinator with SkyConnect firmware. We start the pairing mode for new devices, then press and hold the button on the sensor until the LED starts blinking. The sensor is then detected and added to the system. All main entities are recognized: temperature, humidity, and battery level. Additionally, there is an entity for checking the firmware version and an identification button. As I mentioned earlier, the sensor is an end device and spends most of its time in sleep mode to conserve battery power. And, of course, we can't leave out Zigbee 2 MQTT. The latest version at the time of testing is 2.1.1. Here, I am using a SMLite SLZB06P7 network coordinator, which has also been updated to the latest version. As I mentioned earlier, this sensor is intended for my main smart home system, so I immediately connected it to one of my three Zigbee 2 MQTT add-ons used in it. Just like with iHost, it appears as a version with a round screen. This happens because the same identification data is used here, so the system applies the corresponding converter. However, functionally, there are no differences. All necessary parameters, temperature, relative humidity, and battery level, are available. Battery charge and voltage data may update with some delay, which is normal. Through the MQTT integration, all essential parameters, including an entity for checking firmware updates, appear in Home Assistant and can be used for automations and interface display. One of the most frequently asked questions about such sensors is the data update speed. It is important to understand that this speed is not constant and depends significantly on changes in temperature. I placed the sensor outside, where the temperature is below freezing, and right now, it updates every 10 seconds. When the temperature difference is smaller, updates occur less frequently, currently, every 40 seconds. Later, updates become even less frequent, once every minute to a minute and a half. When the sensor's temperature stabilizes with the actual ambient temperature, updates become quite rare. This is necessary to conserve battery life and prevent unnecessary messages from minor air parameter fluctuations. Here is a graph after I brought the sensor back inside. Initially, when the temperature difference was significant, updates were frequent. Then they became less frequent and eventually stopped once the temperature reached its stable value. As seen in this graph, when there are no sudden temperature changes in the room, data updates occur once per hour. The same applies to relative humidity. If changes are minimal, updates occur once per hour. The greater the change, the more frequent the updates. For comparison, here are the readings from an Acura sensor installed on another balcony. When there are no sharp temperature fluctuations, data updates also occur about once an hour. The same goes for humidity. The only difference, in my opinion, is that this sensor requires slightly smaller parameter changes for an update, but overall, the behavior is very similar. During testing, I compared its readings with my other similar sensors. The overall picture is as follows. Humidity deviations are around 2%, and temperature deviations are up to 0.5 degrees Celsius. For such sensors, these are normal variations, even among devices of the same model placed side by side. For everyday use, this is acceptable. In my opinion, this is a well-made and high-quality sensor. It has good compatibility with various smart home control systems and provides accurate and expected readings. I installed it where I had planned, on one of the balconies, and its readings match my expectations. The only thing left to determine is how long the battery will last. So far, I have not found any obvious drawbacks. It works at the same level as my other sensors. That's all for now. I hope this video was useful and interesting for you. I would appreciate your likes. They help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I will leave links to stores where you can order this sensor, as well as to my Telegram channels, social media, and discussion groups for smart home topics. Join in, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to all.